Hi there guys, Tom Quayle here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back again with something a little bit different this time. Still a review, but we're checking out a microphone today. Now, normally, obviously, I'll do guitars, amplifiers, pedals, but this thing is so interesting and so cool and could be a bit of a game changer that we thought we'd check this out for you. So this microphone is a large capsule, large diaphragm microphone from Townsend Labs, and it's called the Sphere L22. Now, most normal microphones have a single capsule and they record, dependent on their polar pattern, a single sort of sphere around the actual microphone. So if you've got like a figure of eight polar pattern, it will record in front of the microphone and behind the microphone. If you've got a cardioid pattern, it will record just in front of the microphone, for instance, in a certain sphere. But what the L22, the Sphere L22 does, is this is basically a analog modeling microphone that uses two capsules. There's one in the front and one around the back. So at the moment, this microphone is recording a full 360-degree image of the sound using two capsules, as I say, one in the front and one in the back. It's very unusual. And what that allows you to do is to take a single cable out the bottom of the microphone and send that to a stereo pair, which goes into two different preamp channels on my interface, and record the front and the back of the microphone. Now, you might be thinking, well, why is that useful? That's incredibly useful because what that allows you to do via the included DSP software, so that's VST, AAX, Universal Audio's kind of native format. So all the formats you would require for different DAWs and different systems, 32-bit or 64-bit, it allows you to model the cardioid and polar patterns and the kind of frequency response of all of the classic large diaphragm microphones that you can find on the market that cost thousands and thousands of dollars or pounds or euros or whatever currency you're using, really, really accurately, far more accurately than you'll find with modeling microphones that require or use a single capsule. By using two capsules, they can get the polar pattern and the frequency response down to an absolute T. So you take the signal and you record into the microphone, and then using that stereo pair that you plug into your interface, you can use the software to, after the fact, once you've recorded, to change the sound of the audio in fundamental ways. So to change the polar pattern of the microphone that you're using. So for instance, if you record, the microphone records 360 degrees, but if you want to, yet say, use like a U67 microphone, a classic, really, really super high-end microphone that you might find in somewhere like Ocean Way Studios, for instance, that's really, really expensive. This microphone, you can actually take that sound, but you can take the polar pattern and you can change it so it rejects everything behind, so that you get less room noise and a more accurate translation of what you're actually hearing from the front of the microphone. Now, there's loads and loads of ways that you can alter the sound, and classic microphones like a U47, U67, C12s, little kind of small diaphragm pencil microphones, some non-linear kind of flat response microphones, true flat response microphones as well. We'll go through those when we look at the software. You can model all of these and you can change all sorts of parameters, like adding filters to microphones that weren't there originally, changing the axis of where the microphone is actually recording the sound from in real time. Again, all after the fact because of this stereo capsule. It also enables you to record in true stereo from a single microphone. You can actually record, and I'll show you this later when we do some acoustic guitar recording, you can record from the front of the microphone using the first capsule, and the second capsule is actually recording from behind as well, in which case they're basically acting like a mono sound that you can manipulate within the DAW. If you then turn the microphone round so that you're firing into this side of both capsules, you can record in stereo, and effectively you're getting both sides of a stereo field, and you can pan them left or right within the plugin. Again, all after the fact. Now, the other really cool thing about this, before we actually get into some recording examples, and it's really easy, is to show you this within the software. The other thing that's super cool is that this also works natively with Universal Audio's interfaces. So that means two things. You can use their Unison preamp technology to model things like Neve preamps and SSL desks and, you know, the really high-end kind of preamps for this particular microphone, with no latency at all. And you can use their software, the DSP, the Townsend Labs software, which I'll show you shortly, to actually do all of the modeling in real time with about 1.6 milliseconds of latency, so that no human being would ever notice that. You can do that level of latency in effectively real time, and then print that to your DAW as your sound source. So you can actually do, you don't need the plugin in your DAW, you can actually print it down from the Universal Audio hardware, which is very cool. And also the, say a singer for instance, or an acoustic guitarist with headphones on, they can listen to the sound of the microphone with all the modeling applied, big wide stereo field from a single microphone without any issue at all, with no latency. So that's super cool. So what I want to do, I want to show you some examples. At the moment you're listening to my voice, I'll show you how we can manipulate my voice as well. And I'll also show you acoustic guitars and also miking up a cab as well. So it's going to be a little bit long, this, but not too long. And we'll do all of those whilst manipulating the software. Okay, so let's start by looking at the actual software itself and seeing what we can do with the software to manipulate the sounds within the microphone. Okay guys, so I've actually hooked up the microphone here to my Universal Audio Apollo interface, actually to a separate preamp that's attached via ADAT. It's coming in on this stereo pair here of, from my preamp into my Universal Audio Apollo Twin via an optical cable, and I've inserted the plugin, the basic plugin. There's two plugins actually that you provided with the Sphere L22. In this case, we've got the basic plugin, and I'll show you the other plugin, the Sphere 180, shortly. But this is the basic plugin where you've got one microphone. And there's quite a lot you can do here. So you're actually hearing me speak through the L22 right now. And what you've got is, you've got the microphone model on the left-hand side, of which there are quite a lot here. And in the future, they'll be updating this and you can get more of these as well. You can either left-click to move through the microphones or right-click to move back. Or you can click on this little disclosure menu down here and actually select your different microphones. And you've got lots of famous microphones like U67s, 47K, you've got C12s. Different. You've got a ribbon mic in here, an SM57, if we go to hybrid, SM57 here. You can probably hear a little bit as I'm kind of speaking into the microphone here. You can hear this is changing the character of each of the of my voice as I'm speaking, because we're changing the type of microphone. Now, that's the microphone selection. On the middle panel here, you've got your polar pattern selection. Now, microphones like, for instance, the 67, anything that's in blue is a selectable pattern on the actual original microphone. So we've got a cardioid pattern, we've also got an omni pattern, and I'll explain a little bit about these, and a figure of eight pattern as well on the original mic, because those are in blue. But you can also select sub eight, hypercardioid, supercardioid, subcardioid, wide cardioid, and sub omni as well. Now, as I'm doing this, if I select, for instance, omni, probably hear my computer fans in the background, because this is now sampling audio from 360 degrees around the microphone, so you're hearing more room noise, and there you can hear the fans. If I select cardioid, you can hear that disappears, and you can see this graphical representation here. The microphone is rejecting all sound from behind it, and the two capsules work by this area here behind the mic is the second capsule, and the first capsule in front is this capsule here that you can see is picking up audio from the front. If I click behind the mic, there you can see the second capsule picking up sound. Okay, so there's a graphical representation of what's going on, and now we're picking up more from the front again. So you've got those two different capsules from the front and the back that allow you to change the cardioid pattern. So as we go to omni, now both of the actual capsules are being used, and although we're not picking up a huge amount of sound from the back, you can hear that we are picking up more room noise as opposed to this. Now, that again, this is something you could do with the original 67, but you couldn't, for instance, select this particular cardioid, polar pattern, or say a sub figure of eight. So there's a lot of power here in terms of how you set up the microphone flexibility wise. Then we've got a filter. We can select a high-pass filter, and this again is sort of similar to the original microphone. So we've got a high-pass filter with a pad, and just a standard pad. Some of the microphones allow you to actually tailor the actual low frequency roll off of the mic. So here on this SM57, because this is a high sort of SPL microphone, so you tend to record quite loud instruments, it's quite useful to roll off some of that low end, and you can hear that's affecting things as we do that. And you can hear this sounds like an SM57. It's really, really super accurate, and again, the way they've got this accuracy is by having the two capsules front and back, allowing you to really accurately capture the polar pattern and frequency response of a particular microphone, unlike some of the other modelled microphones on the market, which basically just apply an EQ curve, they don't actually change the polar characteristics of the microphone. So in this case, we're getting this nice polar setup going on with the frequency spectrum as opposed to just applying an EQ curve. We can also change the axis. So as we do this, you can see this triangle moving around. This is basically telling the microphone where to pick up audio from. And as I move around to the back, you can hear that the sound is changing ever so slightly. If I select something like the cardioid pattern and we move around to the back and we maybe select an SM57, you can hear the effect this is having on the tone. In this instance, it's quite subtle, but it can be very, very marked, the difference that you've got. You've then got this proximity setting. This allows you to model being closer to the amp, closer to the whatever you're recording, be that an amp or a vocal or whatever. And being closer gives you more low-end thump, and being further away gives you slightly more room sound and also just reduces some of those low-end frequencies as well. You've got your output, and then at the bottom you've got your levels. Now, something that's super cool about this, as well as being able to select all these different microphones and change their polar patterns and so on and so forth, which is pretty cool anyway, is you can actually go into dual mode and you can have two different microphones. So the again, this is just because this is DSP as opposed to being built into the microphone. So now I can select a completely different microphone here. So let's select one of these pencil mics, like a C12, and then we can blend that into the signal, and you can hear we're getting a little bit more detail now on my voice. Of course, I'll show you this on guitars briefly shortly. We can change the alignment, which is quite useful if you're recording, say, an amplifier. It's sometimes you'll set the mics slightly different so that you get a little bit of phase cancellation. And if I start to play with the alignment here, we're just a little bit out of phase. You can hear there it's quite marked in terms of the high-end roll-off. Okay. And again, you've got the same controls of filter and axis. There's your proximity. You've got off-axis correction as well, should you need that, if you don't want to be out of phase. You can link these as well, so they're both the same. Let's just change this back to the C12. Okay, and then you can solo each mic individually as you wish, so you can hear. You can really hear a marked difference between those. Remember, this is all coming from the same microphone. It's not EQ curves that have been applied here. So, and again, we could change this to a figure of eight if you wanted a little bit more detail, a little bit more bottom end, so on and so forth. So, you know, there's quite a lot that you can do there. It's very, very cool indeed. So, let's now move on to showing you this with some acoustic guitar. Okay, so I'm in Studio One here, and I've got an acoustic guitar recorded just here. And I've applied on this track, this is this track here, there's the plugin. Okay, this again is there's two versions of the plugin. This is the Sphere 118. Now, the incredible thing about this is that the microphone can work in stereo. So as opposed to the previous plugin that we had, which was just the standard Sphere plugin, this is, you can see up here, it says Sphere 180. Now these microphones are split. So the front capsule is using this microphone, C12, and the rear capsule is using this LD49. And what this allows us to do is if we record side on with the microphone, and you can see on screen now what I mean by side on, recording into the side of the microphone, we can actually record with these two different mics in stereo and then use this width control to change the stereo image of these particular microphones. And you can see how the polar patterns and frequency response is actually interacting here. It's so cool. So if I was let me just change this so that we've got the standard plugin. So I'm going to remove this. And I'm going to go to my effects here and grab the standard Sphere plugin and just place it on top of this stack here. Now, I do also have it's not a compressor, I'm just adding gain after this plugin via an LA2. There's no compression going on at all, I promise, guys, so I'm not actually doing anything to the signal. So here we've got, let's go back to the standard mode, we've got one microphone, okay? So if I press play here, this is the sound of the acoustic. And we can do all the same stuff, so we can change the polar pattern, so we could go to a figure of eight if we wanted a bit more low end, or omnidirectional, or anything in between if we want a little bit more room noise. And again, apply filters, all that usual stuff, or we could do dual mode for two microphones. If I just close that down, I'm going to remove that plugin. So that was in mono, okay? Even though it looks like a stereo track, what you've got here is it's the two stereo tracks for the two different capsules being combined into mono by the plugin, okay? But if I add in Sphere 180 and place it at the top of my stack here. Now we've got the two microphones, so this kind of looks similar, but now we are truly in stereo. So I can select two different mics here. I'm going to select, because I really love it, the C12 again. I'm going to unlink these and I'm going to grab the 67. Okay, now when we listen, now you can hear a stereo field. Now, the cool thing is I've done nothing here in terms of panning anything. This is what the microphone has recorded. It's recorded stereo for me just by virtue of the fact that we are running two capsules. So you can run the plugin, the standard plugin, or you can run the stereo plugin, this 180 plugin, and it's so cool. So now I can take the width. You can hear there we're back to a mono signal, and then I can really increase that width and get that full stereo field again. Now all of the control still works, so I can play with the polar pattern of each microphone. So for instance, let's go for a figure of eight with the C12 or the LD12. Super, super cool. So if we now add in a little bit of reverb, we get something really quite remarkable. So really, really cool, very, very useful in terms of flexibility. And the bottom line is that this microphone sounds incredible anyway. It's such a detailed, rich sounding microphone, very transparent. If you want really good transparency, the custom options here just give you very, very flat sounding microphones. So let's go for Sphere Direct actually. So this is just the sound of the microphone on its own with no kind of processing other than what the microphone sounds like. So just a great sounding microphone generally, a really, really cool sounding microphone that's going to really enhance your collection. Okay guys, so the final thing I wanted to show you is how this microphone sounds on cabs. So I've recorded my Laney L20 amplifier on the dirty channel and mic'd up the right hand speaker. It's a 2x12 combo and we get this kind of cool sound. Again, you can do all sorts here. You could change the microphones around. I'm going to do a couple of things, just move around here and let you have a listen to how this sounds, and then we'll grab the stereo plugin and do the same thing. Okay, so let's grab the stereo plugin. Let's remove this one and stick the stereo plugin there and have a listen to how that sounds on this source material as well. Okay. Thank you. as you can hear, tons and tons of flexibility, all from that original source audio. That original source audio, that stereo file, there's been nothing done to that. We've just applied this DSP plugin. So you can record your source audio with the Townsend Labs Sphere microphone, and then basically you've got all this flexibility in post using the plugins that come with the actual microphone. You can just download those. If you want to use them, just a real quick note with the Universal Audio, so you get the absolute minuscule amount of latency, basically real time, you need to pay for the plugins, because obviously they're running on the UAD platform. So that's a little bit extra that you need to pay. In fact, quite a bit extra. So factor that into your cost. But generally, we're massively, massively impressed with this microphone. It really is a game changer, or should be a game changer for a lot of people. Having the flexibility to do all of this in post, or if you've got the Universal Audio, be able to print this down into your DAW with these different microphones. Just get this amazing collection of microphones within this single microphone. Really, really amazing. In terms of cost, it's expensive, but it's worth every penny. If you were to buy all of these microphones, the models are so accurate, and it's not just EQ curves, it's modeling the characteristics of each individual microphone so accurately, that if you were to buy all these microphones separately, it would just cost you the earth. So really, it's a fantastic deal, and I really want one for myself. I may have to get one of these for my studio. So there we have it, guys. As usual, check out all the text in the magazine for further details and to see exactly what we thought. My name's Tom Quayle, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.